drop mom off. I also would like to acknowledge the NBC SN fighters, Robert Easter and Terrell Galsha. Also, I'd like to acknowledge Michael Hunter. He will also be fighting on the card. The co-main event. This gentleman, he took this fight on very short notice, but he'll be looking to give it his all come Saturday night. He's an outstanding fighter. He brings it every time he steps into the ring. He comes to us with a 26-1 record with 14 KOs, and he's fighting out of Toronto, Canada. He's originally from Sicily, Italy. He had a great amateur career before returning to his home country of Italy, and he made the 2004 Olympic team. He made his U.S. debut in 2012 with a win over Hector Orosa. Most recently defeated Rafael Cobos in March via 8-round unanimous decision. Phil, will you come up for a few words?
I'm honored and thrilled to be here. First and foremost, I want to thank God. Without him, nothing is possible. All great things come from him. Also, I'd like to thank Al Heyman, and I'd like to thank also Sam Watson. For those who don't know me, I'll introduce myself very briefly. I'm Philip Greco, I'm Italian. I was born and raised in Italy and been traveling from Canada to Italy. As my amateur background, I represented two countries in the amateur games, and not too many fighters can say that they've done that. So let's fast forward a little bit. My only loss was to this man right here, Sean Porter, which there was no problems, no shame at all, world champion, great fighter. I decided to stop boxing because opportunities weren't coming along whatsoever. The only opportunities that were presented to me were, I call them Don King opportunities, where it would cost me money to fight the guy. So I say, you know what, I'm too good looking to fight in the sport, and I have other things in life that I could do and I could be successful of. But then again, I ran into Sam Watson, and I told Sam, I'm done boxing, you know, and he thought I was crazy because I was young, I had a record of 25-1, and I said, let me think about it. He says, I could give you some real opportunities, not Don King opportunities, but real opportunities, and I said, let me call you back. It took me about 6 months, because I did nothing for 2 years. I wasn't supposed, a year ago, I did not think I was going to box ever again. I had other things in my mind, and Sam Watson said, you know what, I'm going to give you some opportunities. It took me 6 months to get in shape. I got in shape. I had a return fight in March. Thank Shawn, he gave me some rounds for sparring for that fight. And real fighters fight. You know, the problem with boxing is a lot of fighters aren't professionals. That's the problem with boxing, is taking a dump. Because fighters aren't being professionals. They wait for the right opportunity. They wait for the right promotion, the right fight, the right money. The right money, the right time is when you want it to be, and I want it to be now. So I'm gonna come. I'm gonna come to win. I'm gonna come to fight. It's gonna be fun. Saturday night, be there. Be there. Thank you.
This next gentleman, I'm very, very familiar with him. He's an outstanding young fighter. He's gonna be one of the main guys of the future who will carry on the torch in this sport. He comes to us with a 16-0 record with 13 KOs. He's out of DeSoto, Texas. He's a 2012 Olympian. And most recently, he dominated Samuel Vargas in the April 11 PBC card. Next up, Errol Spence.
First off, I'd like to thank God, thank Mayweather Promotions, Heyman Boxing, PBC on NBC. And last but not least, I'd like to thank Phil Greco for taking this fight. And he sees this as an opportunity, and he say he's going to have fun in the ring, but it's not going to be that. I come here to make a statement Saturday night, and I'm putting on a great performance and a great show. And you're going to get what you always see with me. You're going to get one-sided action. And you're going to be looking at the future of the sport come Saturday night.
Next up, I'd like to introduce the main event. I'd like to acknowledge K Ken Porter, Shawn Porter's father and trainer, who's an outstanding trainer. This next gentleman, I made a comment the other day. I said one of the things that's very admirable about him, he's willing to get in there with anyone, and I say anyone. He's always calling everyone out, the main guys in his division. The division now, he's an exciting fighter. He comes to us with a 30-1 record with 22 big KOs. He fights out of Cincinnati, Ohio. He's training at the...
I don't give a fuck when I talk first.
Record with 16 KOs, Mr. Adrien Broner. He fights out of Akron, Ohio, and he's fighting out of Las Vegas. His most recent win on Spike TV on March the 13th against Eric Benet. He has very impressive wins over former world champions Devin Alexander and Paul Maldonado. Shawn.
Thank everybody for coming out. Since y'all here, I wanna make sure y'all here with me. It's showtime. What time is it?
Showtime!
What time is it?
Showtime!
All right, I just wanna make sure y'all here with me. Y'all mind me talking first? I don't mind. It's a blessing from God to be here today. I wanna thank him for just blessing me with another opportunity to do what I do on such a big stage. I'm loving it. I always have and I always will. Want to thank the MGM for opening up the doors for us. This will be my first fight in the Grand Garden Arena. Very excited about that. I've closed my eyes every time I've been at those fights, seeing those big fights and visualized myself doing it. So the time has finally come for that. And I want to thank the MGM for that. I want to thank Al Haymon for making this fight possible. PBC, Mayweather Promotions, TGB Promotions, and everyone else out here who is supporting boxing, supporting Showtime, Shawn Porter, supporting Tink Porter, and come Saturday, it's coming real soon, all the talking is done, so I'm glad I got to go first. God bless you guys, have a good one.
I'd like to acknowledge Adrien Broner's trainer, Mike Stafford, who's an outstanding trainer, one of the top trainers in the sport. And this next gentleman, he's a former three-time world champion. He comes to us out of Cincinnati, Ohio, with a 30-1 record, with 22 big KOs.
How many?
22. He's now training and fighting out of the Mayweather Boxing Club.
Hold on. Got it.
Next up, none other than Adrien the Problem Broner.
I gotta start it off like everybody else. You know, thanks to God, of course. But We're gonna go ahead and turn left. You know, thank Al Haymon and Big Bro and all that good stuff. But we're gonna go ahead and let everybody know, like, this is the AB show. This is the start of the AB show. And y'all getting it first live in person. So I'm gonna go ahead and get into it. I'm fighting Shawn Porter, a football player. And I'm fighting his dad. It's like I'm fighting his dad because when he get his check, the check come in his dad's name and then he pays Shawn. And then he makes Shawn sign a check and then he go deposit it in a joint account at the US Bank in Southern. I visit Floyd House a lot. So I see him I see him at the U.S. Bank in Sutherland's out spending Shawn's money. That's why he got the better cars. He got the big Jeep, the big boy Jeep. You gotta hop out of it to get out of it. Then he got the Corvette with the Lamborghini doors. While Shawn, he's either catching an Uber or... See, y'all making this a joke. I'm just telling him. He either catching an Uber or he's hopping out his 2011 CTS, the little one. I just don't get it. That's the difference between me and him, because I paid my dad. You know, I pay my dad for all of this hell that I'm taking. You're not about to live your dream. Then he made him move to Las Vegas. That's his dream. That's his dream that he wanted. He wanted to move out here. He got the girl that Shawn was supposed to have. Either today he got on a better suit. Oh my God, they live together. Damn, I mean, let him live. Let him have some fun, man. I mean, I can't go. It's not gonna happen. It's just not gonna happen for me. So, since they both get the check, if I kick both of their ass, would I get paid twice? Would I get paid twice?
Hey, you know, you probably gonna need to be paid twice.
I'm just saying.
To get up all that child support, baby.
I'm just saying, man.
30% to the taxes, 15% to the first baby.
I'm just saying.
To the second baby. 10% to that trainer, 20% to the... What you got?
We over
the top already.
He hot.
We over the top.
He hot.
I think we're in the zero now. It's either red. It's right through the map.
Got it.
Already, right?
He hot.
You spent the advance.
And all that.
Truth
all
say,
that patent man. Leather, he hot. He got the patent leather hookup on. He got the patent leather sideburns that come with it.
Truth gonna set you free. Trust me.
Nah, y'all looking good though. Y'all looking good though. Y'all looking good, man. Y'all looking good. Y'all looking good. Y'all ready to go to lunch, brunch, Sunday dinner. Nah, man, this is gonna be a great fight though, man. I'm very excited because, to be honest, you know, I like Shawn as a person. He gets so much negative energy from his dad, and that's just the truth. Like everybody you go around, you know, he get the negative energy because of his dad. I was always taught if it's negative, go somewhere else. So I got an opposition for you. After this fight, after I whoop your ass, come sign to about billions. I'm gonna put you in a better car than your dad's. Cause after this fight, he probably try to give you the vet and go buy something new. Don't go for that trick, Shawn. I'm gonna buy you a nicer car than his. And I'm gonna let you spend your own money. The money's gonna come to you and you're gonna spend your own money. It's up to you. I already wrote out the contract. It's ready for you to sign. And Saturday night, we're gonna have fun. Like I told you once before, this is the AB show. I wanna thank Big Bro for giving me the opportunity to be on the side of one of the greatest in the game, in the sport to ever do it. And I'm just blessed, and I'm grateful. Saturday night, I'm gonna put on a show. This boy won't beat me.
This concludes the press conference. I'd like to pose the fighters.
Time for face off. Come on. 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 something on Broner, you know, that stuff, right?
Yeah.
I'll write about the so I'll just do about, you know, a little scene capture about the antics.
What shot? This shot. What y'all wanna see? We eat steaks every night. We don't eat granola bars and water. We make one time. Yeah. Make sure you make quick.
That stuff is in the background, and it came out. That's all. When he
Robert
the Easter, internet stuff, yeah.
Robert Easter kept his cool over there, Mike. I thought he was going to jump in.
Nah, I'm ready to jump in. Cause you know, the dad talked more than the son. Kenny, Shawn is a lovable kid. Just the dad act like he fighting the fight, you know?
The son. So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Sekpak, and you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Sekpak.